The crankshaft position center is located on the left rear of the engine, as indicated by the red arrow, mounted in the transmission bell housing shown in the insert photograph. Working at the engine cover, red arrow, pull off the two front air duct hoses, green arrows. To detach the ducts, pull them straight off the engine cover air filter housing, then pull the front of the duct out of the radiator support and remove it from the engine. Lift up and remove the front engine cover. Then pull the engine cover air filter housing straight up to remove it. The cover is held on by four metal clips that grab onto the rubber mounts, with the front two shown here by red arrows. The rear of the cover has two as well. Once detached, remove the engine cover slash air filter housing from the engine. Working from above the left side of the engine, reach down behind the cylinder head. Disconnect the crankshaft sensor electrical connector, as indicated by the red arrow, by pressing the plastic release tab and pulling it straight off. Next, remove the crankshaft sensor E8 mounting fastener, red arrow. There is not a lot of room, so I use an extension with a swivel attached to an E8 socket on my quarter-inch drive ratchet. Use a mirror before you remove the sensor. If you see debris, like shown here with the yellow arrows, use a low-pressure air to blow it away from the sensor. You want to make sure that the area is clean before removing the sensor so that nothing falls into the hole. Once the fastener is removed, pull the crankshaft sensor out of the engine block. It will slide straight out, red arrow. I have not seen one stuck or frozen in the bell housing before, but this can happen due to corrosion. If it does, spray the sensor with a little penetrating oil and let it soak. Then try again. Rotate the sensor to break it free and then remove it. This photo shows the sensor removed. Install a new sensor and tighten the fastener. Reconnect the electrical connector, install the engine covers, start the vehicle and allow it to idle for about 1 minute. If your check engine light was on, now is the time to clear any fault codes. You're finished. Good job. Thanks for watching. Click here to view the original article, along with hundreds of other DIY content for your car.